Hey everybody, welcome back to Habitat Kitchen. I'm Andrew Beauchamp, and we're officially declaring November Squash Month. First one on the chopping block, spaghetti squash. Let's get some background information. The spaghetti squash first was discovered in Manchuria, China, which is in the countryside of China, around 1850. Spaghetti squash didn't come to America until about 1920, and it still wasn't very popular until World War II, whenever pastas and dried goods were harder to find, the spaghetti squash obviously became more popular. So very, very easy to prepare one of these. I've already washed the outside. All I'm gonna do is do a thin slice down one side, so where the stem is. Squash to cut. There we go. But this flat end is gonna make it easier whenever we go to cut it on this side. Straight down the center here, cutting into two halves. Beautiful! I'm just scraping everything out. I'm just gonna take my spaghetti squash, put them on my pan, and I'm gonna season them. I probably used about a teaspoon of salt and a teaspoon of pepper on top of each one. Sesame oil. This is completely optional. I just love the nuttiness that it brings. I think it's really nice. You don't need much, just a few dashes on each side. Just a tablespoon of oil inside the cavity. And then you're gonna get your hands a little messy and you're gonna rub in the salt and the pepper and the sesame oil all over. Face side down on the pan. And you're gonna stab it a few times in the back. Doesn't sound very nice, does it? I just kinda do like four sets of imprints down the back of the squash. Beautiful. You're gonna wanna take these bad boys, put them into your oven, for about a half hour to 40 minutes. Just make sure you're not overcooking them, because if you overcook them, then your squash is going to literally get squashed. It'll be too overcooked for the strands inside the spaghetti squash to hold up. So check on them at the half hour mark. Oven with those guys. Our spaghetti squash is still a little bit warm, but it's able to be handled, and that's really just where you want it. So stupidly simple, you can already see I picked a few of the strands away. You're just gonna take a fork and you're just gonna push and you can see the noodles coming right out of the squash, which is probably one of the coolest things I can think of. The fact that a vegetable does this is mind blowing to me. Those are the beautiful noodles of the spaghetti squash. Now you can do so much with this. You can use it in the base of a stir fry or in a bowl. You can also do plenty of different flavoring combinations with this because it is such a simple flavor. But today, just to showcase it in its classic glory, I am just going to throw over top some classic red sauce and then we're gonna enjoy it just like that. Now the only thing left to do to this is to taste it. This, pour it into the bowl. Ooh, look at those noodles. Now this dish is completely okay on its own, but to spice it up a little, I highly suggest maybe making a bit of garlic bread to go along with it, something a little bit more carby, but absolutely delicious. I just love that it's a squash. I think it's so cool. I don't know. Vegetables and plants are just, they're the coolest. Thank you guys for coming along with me today. I hope you learned something new. I know I sure did. If you're new here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button down below. We'd love to have you. Till next time, guys. Stay hungry.